While today's AI can do extraordinary things, its functionality has very little to do with the way the human brain works to achieve similar tasks. AI, and specifically machine learning, works by analyzing massive data sets looking for patterns and correlations without understanding the data it is processing. As a result, a machine learning system requiring thousands of tagged samples is fundamentally different from the mind of a child, which can learn from just a few experiences of untagged data. For today's AI to overcome such inherent limitations and evolve to the next phase, artificial general intelligence, we should examine the differences between the brain, which already implements general intelligence, and the artificial counterparts. With that in mind, this series examines in progressively greater detail the capabilities and limitations of biological neurons and how these relate to machine learning. In part one, we examined how a neuron's slowness makes its approach to learning fundamentally different from the thousands of samples required by machine learning. Now we'll take a look at the fundamental algorithm of the perceptron and how it differs from any biological model. The perceptron underlies most machine learning algorithms and is fundamentally different from any model of a biological neuron. The perceptron has a value calculated as a function of the sum of incoming signals via synapses, each of which is the product of the synapse weight and the value of the perceptron from which it comes. In contrast, the biological neuron accumulates charge over time until a threshold is reached. The perceptron has no intrinsic memory. Its value will always be the same for a given set of inputs. The neuron, on the other hand, combines its inputs with the current state of its internal charge, so there is a modicum of memory, and the output may be different for any given set of inputs. While many say the perceptron's value is analogous to the spiking rate of the neuron, this analogy breaks down because the perceptron ignores the relative spike timing or phase of an incoming signal and considers only the frequency. As a result, the biological neuron could also respond differently based on the order of the spike arrival, while the perceptron cannot. To provide an illustration, here is the brain simulator with a few neurons. First, see how the neuron in, which is firing continuously, is connected to the neuron out with a synapse of 0.25. You can see that the out neuron accumulates the incoming charge until the threshold is reached, and then it fires. Now consider this neuron, stimulated by two input synapses, weighted +1/2 and -1/2. If the inputs alternate, the neuron will never fire, because each positive input is followed by a negative input, which zeroes out the accumulated charge. If the inputs fire more randomly, the neuron will fire whenever two positive spikes arrive with no intervening negative spike. The perceptron model doesn't support this function because it ignores the timing and phase of the incoming signals. In both cases, the perceptron would see the average input frequency is 0.5 because it's half the maximum rate. So the perceptron model will give the same output, 0, in either of these two cases, because the summation of the weighted inputs will always be 0, regardless of the input timing. This means that the perceptron model cannot be reliably implemented in biological neurons, and vice versa. This is such an essential difference between the neural network and the biological neuron that I will devote a separate video to exploring it in greater depth, along with other biological factors which make today's AI different from the brain's function at a very fundamental level. The biological neuron models allow for single spikes to have meaning, rather than having a spike train represent a value. As the overwhelming majority of the brain's neurons spike only rarely, it is likely that many neurons do have specific meanings. For example, since you understand what a ball is, it is likely that your brain contains a ball neuron, or perhaps many, which fire if you see a ball or hear the word. In a biological model, that neuron might fire only once when a ball is recognized. The perceptron model of firing rates doesn't allow this, however, because the firing rate of a single spike isn't defined. In the next video, I'll discuss how the connections in the brain are not organized in the orderly layers of machine learning, and how this requires some modification to the basic perceptron algorithm, which may prevent backpropagation from working at all. Thanks for watching. Be sure and subscribe to be notified when more videos in this series are available. And for now, watch this interesting video.